that you should buy the score outside. And also that we should focus on performing. So we never thought to do this in the past. I just wanted Helaine to share, and she wasn't prompt for this until today. The whole experience of learning something where you have no reference for, I think the students are so used to going to YouTube for reference now. They don't often don't even know who the performer is. I'm like, who did you listen to? YouTube. So it's daughters. So just wanted her to share her own experience of learning something that she had no reference for.
Well, I think there were like three main things for how I approached this score. The first thing was, as Ms. Bryan said, it was based on a spiritual. So I still went to YouTube and I listened to the spiritual that this piece is based off of, and that helped me get a basic idea of what it should sound like. And the second thing is the I try to go in like the emotions that I'm trying to express through the piece, because music is a language of feelings, as my teacher would always tell me. So I think the best way for the audience to understand the piece is through the transfer of feelings. So I try to figure out what emotions I wanted to express, and my interpretation would be based on that. And finally was the Zoom meeting with Ms. Bryan, which you saw. Getting input from the composer was really helpful